Hello guys, I welcome all of you to today's Farmcast. And guys, today is the third day and I have chosen alphabetically, of course, the five drugs of choice we'll discuss today. And obviously at last I'll discuss one common concern that you guys have during your preparation, right? Let's begin with the first disorder for today. Guys, the disorder is ADHD, or Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder. Now, the drug of choice for ADHD, it has been asked quite a number of times, so it is preferred to be asked. And guys, think, what is the drug of choice for ADHD? I bet almost 100% of you would know the answer, that the answer is methylphenidate, right? So here, we need not stop just at methylphenidate, right? We need to think what else they can ask. So for that, I'll tell you two things. One, that is, methylphenidate can worsen tics, right? And in which disorder you can see tics, right guys? Which disorder? Tourette syndrome. And you'll be surprised to know that ADHD is frequently seen with Tourette syndrome. That means you might have to deal with patients who have both ADHD as well as Tourette. Now, in those patients, can I use methylphenidate? No, obviously. Why? Because it worsens tics. So one condition where methylphenidate is contraindicated is ADHD with Tourette. That is one concern. Second concern here is, see guys, methylphenidate, what is it? It is a CNS stimulant, and you know that stimulants can be abused, and there is always a risk of addiction or dependence with drugs like methylphenidate. Now let me tell you a scenario. A kid has ADHD and there is a family history of drug abuse. Anyone from the family, right, has a history of drug abuse. Now it has been seen that, guys, drug abuse, it has some genetic component, so that kid might be at higher risk for drug abuse. So if I use methylphenidate for ADHD, what could happen is, into his adulthood, the kid could abuse methylphenidate or amphetamine, that which is quite similar to methylphenidate. So I've told you two conditions where, even if there is ADHD, I'll not be using methylphenidate. What are those two conditions, guys? Recall, one is Tourette syndrome, second one is family history of drug abuse. Now, in these two conditions, if there is ADHD, what is my drug of choice? Think, guys. So that is the next level questions which are asked in AIIMS and JIPMER and PGI like exams. And then your answer would be atomoxetine. Guys, I'll repeat once again, your answer would be atomoxetine. And atomoxetine is a selective norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor. It is not SNRI. SNRI is serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor, where we have drugs like venlafaxine, duloxetine. Atomoxetine is a selective norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor, and it was found out that this drug is not a very good antidepressant, but it is a very good drug if it is used in ADHD with these disorders, right? So all in all, ADHD drug of choice is methylphenidate. ADHD with Tourette or ADHD with family history of drug abuse, drug of choice is atomoxetine. So that is the take home away message, guys, here. Let us move on to the next disorder, that is adrenal cancer. So adrenal cancer, what is the drug of choice, guys? It has been asked a couple of times as well. And what is the drug of choice? Think, what is the drug of choice for adrenal cancer? Guys, again, this is an easy one. Drug of choice for adrenal cancer is mitotane. So mitotane is a drug which is adrenolytic, means it selectively kills the cells of adrenal glands, that is adrenal cortical cells are killed by mitotane. And see, remember, the mainstay of treatment of adrenal cancer, you might have studied in surgery, is surgical resection. So surgical resection is the mainstay of treatment in case of adrenal cancer. But in those cases where there is high risk of recurrence, then we go for the drug, and that the drug of choice is mitotane, which is given for 5 years. Now let me tell you a little bit on the follow-up. See guys, if I give mitotane, which is an adrenolytic drug, means it will, you know, kill the adrenal cortical cells, then your adrenal glands cannot produce steroids, glucocorticoids, as well as mineralocorticoids, which means what? Post mitotane therapy, you might have to give hydrocortisone as well as fludrocortisone for treatment of adrenal insufficiency. Right guys, so here are the takeaway messages. Adrenal cancer, what is the drug of choice? Mitotane. How long is it given? 5 years. Let us move on to the next disorder, akathisia. So I discussed a little bit about akathisia with acute dystonia yesterday, right? So akathisia, what is the drug of choice? Akathisia, what is the drug of choice, guys? Think. This has been asked again. Many times it has been asked. Akathisia, guys, remember the drug of choice are beta blockers. Beta blockers like propranolol is the drug of choice. It is the first line drug. It is our first go-to drug in case of akathisia. Now, if they ask, they can ask you like what other drugs are used, guys. The second line drug are anti-muscarinic drug like benztropine. It's an anti-muscarinic drug that can be used, right? Or I can also use benzhexol, which I discussed yesterday, can also be used. Third line drugs are benzodiazepine. So why benzodiazepines are third line drug in case of akathisia? Because in clinical trials, it has been seen that benzodiazepines can actually increase mortality in patients of schizophrenia. That is the reason why they are third line. Nevertheless, if the patient is not responding to beta blockers, if the patient is not responding to anticholinergics, we don't have anything else, we go to benzodiazepine. So here, why have I told you all the three lines? Because here there is an MCQ that is possible. All of the following are used in akathisia except, right? So whatever is left, that could be your answer. Now regarding akathisia, guys, first of all, they might not give you akathisia. They might give you a presentation. So how does akathisia look like in the patient? The patient with akathisia is restless, right? He is pacing around. He has a continuous desire to move around. Now if these words are present, you're dealing with akathisia. Second thing is, you need to remember, they can ask you which is the most common EPS. Most common EPS is akathisia, right? Most common is akathisia. Earliest is acute dystonia. I told you yesterday. Now let's move on, guys, to the next disorder. It is ABPA or allergic bronchopulmonary aspergillosis. So what is the drug of choice for ABPA? Now this is one of the doubts that I frequently get. And think, guys, think, which is the drug of choice for ABPA? Right. So guys, for ABPA, if you look at the disorder, allergic means it is a hypersensitivity reaction. That is your clue. And for hypersensitivity, what do we use to treat, guys? To suppress that immune reaction, what do we use? We use steroids. So guys, steroids, to be precise, prednisolone is the drug of choice for allergic bronchopulmonary aspergillosis. But then you might have seen that antifungal drug like itraconazole is also used in ABPA. So what is its role? See, the role of ABPA is on long-term therapy when you want to decrease the dose of steroids. For long-term, when I use itraconazole, the dose required in ABPA for steroids, it decreases. And I don't need to tell you why decreased dose of steroids is better for the patient. All of you know that, right? So which means what, guys? Remember, two things. Drug of choice for ABPA, steroid, prednisolone. Antifungal of choice is itraconazole. Though I can also use voriconazole, but the preferred one is itraconazole. Now guys, the last disorder for today, it is allergic rhinitis, or which is also known as hay fever in common language, right? Common man's language, hay fever or allergic rhinitis. Think, guys, what is the drug of choice for allergic rhinitis? Now many of you might think it is an allergic rhinitis. That means a second generation antihistaminic like cetirizine or levocetirizine or loratadine can be the drug of choice. You're wrong, guys. No. Antihistaminics are not the drug of choice in allergic rhinitis. Think again, I told you, right? Allergy, which is the best class of drug in allergy? Steroids again. So allergic rhinitis, the drug of choice are steroids, and the preferred route is nasal spray. So nasal spray, we can give drugs like budesonide or baclomethasone or fluticasone, can be given by inhalational nasal spray. And second line drug, or you can say add-on drug, right? If you want to add another drug for better effect, then you can go for second generation antihistaminics. Means here, antihistaminic of choice are second generations like cetirizine, levocetirizine, loratadine, all these drugs. Or you can go for inhalational antihistaminics. Guys, sometimes they ask you, which of the following is an inhalational antihistaminic? Think, can you recall at least one antihistaminic which is not inhalational, but which can be given by intranasal route? At least one. Guys, if you remember, we discussed about drugs like azelastine, olopatadine. These two are most commonly used. Azelastine. So at least remember two antihistaminics from second generation, which are given by inhalational route. These are azelastine and olopatadine. So what did I tell you, guys? Allergic rhinitis, drug of choice, steroids. Right? To steroids, I can add antihistaminics. But remember, if there is a kid with allergic rhinitis, then I would better avoid steroids in that kid. So in children, the preferred drug, or usually the parents, you know, for any kid, the parents, they would always ask about the drawbacks, side effects of drugs. So what parents mostly choose for kids for allergic rhinitis is nasal spray of chromolin sodium. Now, if you remember, we discussed in our lectures the safest anti-asthmatic drugs. These are chromolin sodium and nedochromil, right? So that is the reason why in children, chromolin nasal spray is more preferred. So guys, that is what we had to discuss today. 5 important disorders and their drugs of choice, right guys? At last, as I discuss every day, one common concern, and today's concern is an important one. And this question that I get from students is, sir, how to master a subject which I am weakest in? And I feel sometimes that I wish sometimes that this subject did not exist for me, right? So it usually happens. What we do is we close our eyes to a subject we don't like, and it keeps on getting worse to worse, right? So guys, what to do about those subjects? So let me take an example. Suppose pharmacology is your weak link in your 19 subjects, and you don't love pharmacology, don't like pharmacology, but still you'd like to get a decent amount of questions right in the exam. So how to go about that? So guys, the only thing you can do now is you can plan your revision differently. How? Let me tell you. Suppose I'm taking it for example. Don't think that these are the absolute number of days. For example, let us say you have chalked out 5 days for pharmacology and 10 hours a day, right? So 10 hours a day, 5 days, it comes out to 50 hours. But if pharma is a subject which I'm weaker in, it is never advisable to do bolus revision for any subject. And for that matter, if you are weaker in a subject, then you should break it down multiple times. For example, see what I'm telling here is, I would not revise 10 hours a day, I would rather revise 2 hours a day. Alright, I'll revise 2 hours a day, and I'll revise it for 25 days, which means, again, 25 into 2 comes out to 50 hours. So I'll be revising the same 50 hours, but spread across more number of days. And what this gives me is, every day, after I finish revising for 2 hours, I'll take out 10 to 15 minutes, and I will see what I had revised yesterday and day before yesterday. So you are revising. So this is called as series of revision, multiple revision, right? You are revising today as well as you are revising what you have studied yesterday and day before yesterday. And guys, if you do this, you will see that even after closing your eyes, right, you can flip through the pages in your brain. You can flip through the pages of your notes in your brain, and that is when you reach the epitome of perfection, guys, right? So that's all for today, guys. Lots of love to all of you. This was Dr. Ranjan. Take care. Bye-bye.